Oh, I got a fish.
There you go, Auntie, is it?
I have no idea what
that's
it is.
Pretty good size, isn't it?
Nice one.
I think you do have one.
Fish, Bobby.
You gotta catch them pretty fast. The guy don't show up till 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Go fishing.
Well, I got one too.
First hookup is three. Look at that. Look at that. That's what I'm talking about. God, that's great. Oh my goodness.
Holy cow, that's a big fish. God, you see him come get that wake bait? What a strike. Holy cow, what a strike. Look at that fish. The first fish I caught on that wake bait. The very first fish I caught on that. I don't even remember what it's called. Cajun wake. A Cajun wake. The first bass I catch is a giant. Look at that. Look at that fish. Holy smokes. He come up and ate it off the top of the water. It's really not a topwater bait, though. It's a wake bait. We've been making our own for years. And I got with Lucky Strike, and I said, we got to have a wake bait. We got to make one. And they came up with one. And I don't even think this is the best color in the world, but that bass right there thought it was a pretty good color. Holy cow. Oh, golly. Look at the size of that fish. Oh, my goodness. That's a big fish. Look at that.
Right,
look at that, Joe.
Healthy. Very healthy.
Wow. Look at the belly on that girl.
What do you think,
6 pounds. And she is hooked, too. God, I can't even turn loose that bait. The hooks are so sharp. God, look at that big fish. Look at that big fish, Joe. Hey, Joe, you got to take my picture. You got to take my picture, man.
This is a big fish.
This is a big fish. Golly. Here you go, buddy. Here you go. I know the sun's kind of wrong, but
does this mean when I catch the big one, you're going to take a picture of me?
You got to catch a big one first, pal. Here you go. Wait a minute. Yeah. Now it might not be shadows.
I don't take one of anything, Jimmy. You delete what you don't want.
Got it?
Yeah.
Ooh, gotta get you back in the water, girl. Don't keep them out of the water very long to take their picture. Don't do that. She's wanting some more sugar. She's thinking about coming up and asking for some more sugar. Maybe she's not. This wake bait, it's called a Cajun Baby. It's by Lucky Strike. I actually think Bobby Dennis designed this bait. And you know, to me, that is not exactly the best color in the world. I like chrome colors, but that's a beautiful color. And I'm not saying that. It's got eyes that are shining just like shad. And this is what the fish is seeing down there on the bottom. They got the little red on there like I like to put all my baits. It's got white on the bottom. It's got extremely good hooks. Extremely good hooks. Got a big split ring on it, so it's got, and this bait wakes. It does not dive. It looks like a diving bait, but it does not. And let me tell you, wake baits are baits that they don't see very often, and they will absolutely smoke them sometime. It's better after the spawn. Sometimes you can catch them before the spawn, but it's better after the spawn, summertime bait. It's an incredible schooling fish bait. And I'll do some videos and put up on YouTube about some things that we do with wake baits, because we've been fishing them for years. It's kind of one of those pro secrets. They don't talk about them much because we take actual stick baits, you know, like jerk baits. We take jerk baits and that float, and we make wake baits out of them. It's what we do, but it's quite a bit of work and effort. But you know, you don't need many of them. You don't ever hang them up because you got them up on top of the water. You'll finally just wear some of them out because you caught so many fish on them. But the big deal is that it's a lot of work to do it. And, you know, to have one that you can take right out of the package and do nothing other than tie it on and catch a 6-pound fish, the very first fish on it, is amazing.
Yep.
Ooh, come out of that tree.
Yep.
Come up out of that tree. That's what I was talking about earlier.
A little more meat.
Coming out of that tree. Suspended in those treetops.
I won't leave to put the slack in there this time to get him off.
Yeah, coming out of those treetops. That's the first one that's done it, but I bet you some more do it. Man, that is awesome. I mean, pure awesome. Pure awesome.
Jimmy, look where the bait is.
Hooked him on the outside of the mouth.
We're going to bring him in this way because I don't want to break a loop.
Hook him on the outside of the mouth. You're going to break that rod grabbing a hold of him.
That's not mine.
It's not your rod. You don't care. I don't mind.
You see it fall off?
Yeah, I like that. God, the truth hurts. I don't care. It's not mine. You break that rod and grab it in the middle like that.
No,
I don't
care. I laid him down the front of the mirror and just flipped off.
I don't care. Oh, are they coming up eating that bait? I told you I gave you the best color, didn't I?
This portion of Jimmy Houston Outdoors has been brought to you by Mercury Marine. Go boldly. Jimmy Houston Outdoors, America's favorite fishing show, is brought to you by Tracker Boats. Call 1-800-TRACKER today. By Mercury Marine. Go boldly. By Soft Science, supreme comfort footwear for the angler. By Shell Rotella, the engine oil that works as hard as you do. And by Super Start Batteries, available exclusively at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
I just say, don't catch one now. We have a problem, folks.
I got one too. There's a school of them there.
Issue.
I got one too. Hey, I'm trying to back us up.
Yeah, I can tell you're trying to back me up.
You're all right.
You don't want to lose the bait, but you don't care about the fish.
I don't care about the fish. I got my fish, hot dog. There's another one with him. It was a school of them.
I caught mine in a tree. What about you?
I caught him right where you caught yours. I was following back behind it. Where's your fish, Joe? Here's mine. Where's yours, buddy?
Take a good picture of that one. I can't believe you allowed me
your
to
fish is in
up.
The tree.
Can't believe you.
What's your fish doing in the tree? You ought to know better, and we're going down.
Now you leave my fish alone.
Let me see your rod.
You leave my fish alone.
Let me see your rod.
Leave my fish alone.
Let me see your rod.
I'm not leaving you. My rod? What do you think? I'm crazy?
There. You're going to have to retie after all that. Here, hang on. Don't fall.
I turned anyone out there.
Okay. You're going to have to retie anyway. All I did is cut it off for you.
Well, this one.
There was another one with that one. Oh.
This is the first one that has really stuck it down deep.
There was another one with mine, so there was at least three fish there.
Yeah.
But I caught him right the same spot you caught yours. While you're catching him in that open water, those are school fish running around. They're school fish, and they're just running around out here chasing shad. You caught that one out of a tree. But those you're catching in open water are school fish, and they're just cruising around in open water. They got through spawning, and they're schooling back up again.
Jimmy, excuse me, you don't have... Thank you. I mean, we're down deep in this one here. Hanging in a tree.
Boy, that is some dynamite stuff right there. Woohoo! There's another one right here too. I saw him. I think he was actually the smallest one of the three.
You're probably gonna try to catch one after you cut my line off.
Yeah, I cut your line off. He's gonna have to retie.
I remember that.
Can we come back here and hook him for you? Can you handle that?
I worked for this.
You did.
There is no doubt about it.
You did. What's a good fish?
Will you take a picture of these things like this?
You put the fish back in the water before he dies.
No, will you take a picture?
Joe, they cannot breathe out of the water.
Well, you're the one that was hanging him.
Got it.
Yeah, right. Well, you believe that?
Poor fish. I got it. I'm telling you, I took a picture of you and your bait. I suppose you want to take that bait home with you now and throw it over around your dock. You can throw that around off your boat at Table Rock and catch it.
That's already a foregone conclusion.
I know. They'd probably take the rod and reel, too. There he is. He got it sitting still. It's not a very big fish, I don't think. He's not bad. I thought he was a lot smaller than that. He just come up and snapped it right off the top of the water. Wasn't hooked very good, either. Perfect catch. I heard him come up and get it. Ooh, nice one. Ooh, a good one, Joe. Yeah, that fish come right out of that tree. I mean, right out of that tree. That's a nice fish.
You're going to catch him when he's trying to teach him how to swim.
The barbs aren't in.
Got shoulders on him. Shoulders on him.
Jump one more time.
You almost look like Bill Dance up there doing all
well,
that back and forth.
I just
want
to kind of wear him out so he doesn't flop when I grab him with the top water.
I get the hooks out of you. Don't worry. If I get in there, I got a fishing line trick. I'll take it out. Totally painless. I've taken hundreds out. I've never felt a thing. It's not a problem. I'll take that hook right out of you.
I can bet you just can't say you've never heard a thing.
I've heard a few choice words when I've taken them out of people. No, it doesn't hurt. I'm telling you. Go ahead and stick one in there. I'll show you. I'll prove it to you.
No, my dad just showed me how to snap one out. I said, don't show me how to snap one. Show me. Your...
I got that one. I'm getting in this calmer water, having to let that bait sit there a little bit longer. Oh, come here, baby. You want to get this for me, Joe, since you're down there on your knees? Hey, Joe, you dropped the hooks over the side of the boat. You get the hooks. I'll get the bass. Oh, man, that guy's got every hook in him. Every hook. Joe, I gave you my needle nose.
My needle nose?
Yep. Gotta have them, I'm afraid.
My line is twisted to who knows what.
Gotta have them. Fish cannot feel pain. You know, you see that and talk about getting hooks in your body. They can't feel pain. They're cold-blooded. So when you're doing that, you're really not hurting the fish at all. You want to be as careful because you don't want to really damage them or injure them. But they can't feel that. When I kind of pitch them back in, you know, I know that, you know, probably releasing the fish down over the side of the boat gently is kind of a good way to do it. There's nothing wrong with that. That's cool. But let me tell you, as you get older, bending over and getting back up is a little harder than it used to be. So, but when you throw them in, just kind of turn them where they just dive head in. You know, they do that all the time out there feeding. They jump out of the water and come back down head first. It doesn't hurt them a bit.
Jimmy's Look Back is brought to you by Tracker Boats. Call 1-800-TRACKER today.
Here we go. Well, they're eating that albino. I'm telling you, they are eating that albino. Come here, buddy.
Whoa. Wow.
Boy, that's...
Look how fat that fish is.
Those are nice crappie right there. I guarantee you. Those are really, really nice crappie.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, you got one, too.
I'll tell you what, Jim, I got to tell you something about this one right here. I was out here last week. Man, what a slab.
You caught that same one, released him?
Hey, no. I took my marks a lot and put that mark down his back.
Oh,
that's
yeah,
the same.
Right. Hey, I had a guy ask me the other day, what causes that black line down there?
Hybrid black crappie.
A hybrid black crappie.
Yes.
I had a buddy of mine. We were crappie fishing the other day, and he asked me about that. And I really didn't know.
Boy, look at the shoulders on
that
puppy.
That's a nice one right
look
there.
Look at that.
That is a nice one.
That's about 2 inches thick across the back.
That is a good crappie right there. Easy in
there. Get
that
live well.
Thank you, sir.
Let me get that live well on there, Jim.
That is a nice fish. You know what, Wally, I feel kind of sorry for all these cars going by. I mean, everybody's going to work. Here it is early in the morning. Everybody's heading to work, and here we are.
Well, work is for people that don't know how to fish.
You're right. Work is for people that don't know how to fish. Since I'm not smart enough to make a living doing anything else, I just fish. That's all I do.
I hear you.
I kind of enjoy it.
You're crappie.
I kind of enjoy it.
There he is.
He was down there a little deeper, wasn't he?
Yeah, that fish was down about 12 foot.
Ooh, that's a nice one, too. Yeah, they're all nice. That is a nice one, too.
Come here, big boy. Let's flip you up right here. Boy, you can't hardly grip them.
A good
hello
crappie.
Down there.
That is a good crappie right there.
You won't have to put him on a measuring stick. Let me ease back here, Jim.
Jimmy's Look Back has been brought to you by Tracker Boats.
Ooh, I heard that one. I got a bite too. We both got a bite at the same time. Well, one side of the boat, the other side of the boat. That's funny, Joe. That's the last one I had. That's a good one right there. Oh my goodness.
You pull me together. There you go.
Looky there. Looky there.
I think yours might be a little bit.
Well, of course it is. Looky there. There's a pair to draw two right there. Oh, they're about the same size.
Yeah, they're close.
They're about the same size.
Just, I'll take mine back.
Back when, I wanted to take the pressure off. Back when we were kids, Joe and I used to double date, and we would always find really good-looking girls, and occasionally when we got ready, Joe was real bashful, and so we'd take the girls back home at the end of the evening. He would always worry about the parents of the girls getting really upset, so I would have to walk his girl back to the house at the end of the night, and I'd always give his girl a kiss just so she'd be have a good night kiss.
Give me my girlfriend back.
Hey, no, already.
That's mine. That's mine.
No, it's good. Look at the bait.
Open it. Take it out. Take it out. Take it out.
You take it out. Don't you're going to fool with it. Just a second. Don't hook yourself.
The good night kiss is what I did. Thank you, Jimmy.
Get the hook out of the fish. Did you notice he never even touched the fish? That's the reason I had to kiss his girlfriend for him.
Oh, that's not. We'll have a clue for the. Man, now you show them to me. Get them here.
We're having problems. You get penalized 30 minutes at MLF for not only letting a boat fish touch a carpet. Careful, don't bend my hooks.
Don't bend your hook. You didn't have to catch it right there. Holy smokes.
It wasn't even hooked to that. Jojo, I don't.
I don't.
You got. You're bending the hook in.
No, I'm not.
You are. You had the other.
I backed it off.
Get back here on the other end of the boat where you belong.
Well, I'm glad I got that one.
look at what he did to my line. He had the pliers all over my. Look at that. Look at the line.
Pliers back.
Look at. You'll get back here and back in the boat where you belong. Don't you come up here again. Jeez. Hey, Wiz. I bet he's caught 30 trees today. Don't say anything about it, but he's had.
How many?
I got his bait out of a tree a minute ago, and I looked up there and I said, what is that moving in that tree? And I looked up there, there's a mama coon and three babies trying to get after his bait. They thought a doggone crawdad or something had crawled up in that tree.
Yeah.
Jimmy Houston knot. Double your line. Let it go through the eye of the bait. Lay the double line on the index finger of your left hand. Wrap that four times. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Back through the hole in the middle. Tighten it down. Perfecto, mi amigos. Yes. Can you believe that? He threw to the bank, I threw out to a tree, and both of those fish struck exactly the same time, maybe like 3 seconds apart.
They were twins.
Oh, they were twins. Mine were much larger. I'm going to throw back that tree again. If I'd have been Joe, I'd have thrown back the tree where I caught that.
I did.
Jimmy Houston Outdoors is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's. Your adventure starts here. By High Seas, when the money's on the line. By Jackson Kayak and Vantage Fisherman. By Orion Coolers, never lose your cool. And by Lucky Strike, where preparation and opportunity collide. Houston's Helpful Hints is brought to you by Jimmy Houston High-Tech Performance Fishing Rods.
A wake bait, one of the specialized baits in fishing that you're just not going to go out there and throw every day, like a spinner bait or a jig or a plastic worm, a sinking worm. It's a bait that's specialized and really and truly not a lot of fishermen fish with them, and they're missing a big mistake because not only is it a great fish catching bait, it's one of the very best baits that you can use as far as just fun, just pure fun, and it'll catch them when a lot of other baits won't. When to use that bait? The very best time is after the fish have got through spawning. One of the reasons is that bass suspend after they get through spawning. They cannot go deep immediately, so they don't move back to their summer holes right after a spawn. They move out and they'll get in the tops of trees, on points, around boat docks, in bushes, usually 2 to 5 foot deep. 4 or 5 foot over 20 foot of water, that's probably the optimum that you're looking for right there if you can find that. You can run a wake bait over the top of that, and it really, really causes those fish from coming a long way and hit. The dynamite action on that, the wake on top of the water, they just really can't stand it. It draws fish from long distances. The other time where it works really, really good is in when you have schooling fish, particularly in really clear water lakes. And if the water's very muddy, fish don't probably school on top of the water. But if they're chasing shad around on top of the water, this is a dynamite bait for schooling fish. Works really good for stripers too, by the way. But for bass that are schooling, if you got a lake that's got spotted bass in it, one of the places where this bait really became popular was Table Rock Lake over in Arkansas. A lot of schooling fish, a lot of those fish are spotted bass, Kentucky bass we call them, and you just can catch better with a wake bait than you can anything else. And the cool thing about a wake bait, you can throw it up there in a foot of water, drag it back being 60 foot, and still get a bite. Don't forget that you can catch a bait on a bass on a wake bait when you can't catch them on anywhere else. Cajun Wake.
Well, it's late in the day and the sun's getting low. Caught me a big one, but I let it go. I sure had fun just watching him stretch my line.